I've covered various methods of capturing and digitizing video on my channel, some better than others. But here is one of the most unique ways of doing it that was marketed, a webcam. As the Intel Pro Video PC camera from 2001 says right here on the front of its packaging, import video and audio. Video in, excitement out. Audio/video input plug imports existing video from your camcorder or VCR to your PC, cables included. And here it was advertised in a J&R catalog. Intel Pro PC camera. Import video from your VCR or camcorder to your PC. Add video and audio to your webpage. Create a PC movie or make a video phone call. Up to 640 by 480 USB. And the original price was $129.99, but there was a $30 rebate, expires May 31st, 2001, which brought the price down to $99.99. System requirements were a 266 MHz Pentium MMX or 300 MHz Celeron, Windows 98 to Windows XP, 32 megs of RAM, 250 megabytes of hard drive space, and of course a compatible sound system and speakers, and an internet connection for the software that was included to make video phone calls. Inside the box, you get the webcam itself with an attached USB cable, an AV cable, a CD-ROM with software on it, and a quick start guide. Specifications and features include a built-in microphone, which may not sound like something to brag about, but Intel had a previous webcam which did not have any audio capabilities. If you wanted audio, you needed to record it separately through your sound card. Again, it mentions the audio-video input port with cables to connect to your camcorder or VCR, CCD sensor for enhanced image quality and low-light performance, multi-element lens for improved clarity and minimal distortion, VGA resolution 640 by 480 sensor, 50 degree field of view, focus distance 10 centimeters to infinity, frame rate up to 30 frames per second for full motion video. Despite the box being rather dirty and beat up, this webcam has obviously never been used because it still has this protective cap stuck on the end of the USB cable, which is something you definitely don't see anymore. I don't know if they were worried about static discharge or something. It also has this big sticker on the cable telling you to install the software first before plugging it in. And that software CD has never been opened. On the webcam itself, you get a manual focus adjustment, a privacy shutter to block off the lens. There's that snapshot button. Here's the stand designed to perch atop a CRT monitor. This one was manufactured on October 5th, 2001, or is that May 10th? And it was made in Taiwan or China. They're not sure. There was a previous version of this webcam which looked very similar, except it did not have a microphone or any audio capabilities. It had an RCA jack on the back for a video input, but that was strictly video, no audio. On this one, the AV input looks a bit like an S-video jack, except it has this extra pin at the top. That's because it's not for S-video, but rather for this proprietary cable which splits out into composite video and left and right audio. It can also take pictures at VGA resolution as JPEG, BUMP, or FPX, which I've never heard of. The quick start guide shows all the different types of webcams and digital cameras Intel had at the time, including the one that LGR reviewed. Unfortunately, it doesn't really tell you much other than to put in the CD and run the setup program, and then tells you if you want more instructions to get the online manual from Intel's website, which surely is no longer available. Here is the period correct computer I'm going to use. A Compact Desk Pro EN from 2001. I have the webcam set up but not plugged in yet because I'm going to do what it said and install the software first. Okay, as soon as I put in the CD, this is what popped up, so I'm going to install it. Welcome to the Intel Create and Share software setup. Live face-to-face video calling is here today. Create your own full motion streaming videos. You can broadcast live video and audio over the internet to a website you create and own. And of course it wants me to restart the computer. If you haven't already connected your camera, do it now. So I will do as instructed. Intel PC Camera CS431. Open the camera's privacy shutter. For the best results, ensure the room is brightly lit. Click Next. But we're still not seeing anything from the camera. Okay, some reason it wasn't working in that test program, but here it is working in Intel Scene Recorder software. The image is all blown out and the color is oversaturated and the frame rate is terrible, but otherwise it's clearly working. So let me see if I can improve that image. Okay, I set it to optimize the frame rate and manually adjusted the exposure, and that seems to have made a massive improvement, so now I'll actually try recording some video. Okay, is this thing recording? Let's get some movement from the cassette recorder and just see what kind of image we get from this webcam. Okay, that's the recorded video. Okay, is this thing recording? Let's get some movement from the cassette recorder and just see what kind of image we get from this webcam. So I'm going to put it in my documents, video 001. What do you mean slide not found? Well, despite that error message, it actually did save the video file. The video is 320 by 240 resolution at 20 frames per second, and the video codec is Indio Video 5. And here in the advanced options, we can choose different resolutions. I could bump it up to 640 by 480, but if I did, I'm sure the frame rate would plummet, so 320 by 240 is probably the best we're going to really get if we want any kind of decent frame rate. Speaking of which, there is no manual setting for the frame rate. You just get this nondescript smoothness option. It's saying smoother settings result in larger recorded videos, which can cause performance problems. So I'm going to try bumping it up a bit and see what that does. And under audio, you get a choice of voice quality or CD quality. Okay, this is a test with the smoothness setting maxed out to see if I'm now getting 30 frames per second, like the box claimed this camera is capable of. Okay, that actually gave us 30.01 frames per second, so you can't complain with that. And here is a test of recording video at 640 by 480 resolution to see what that looks like. Yep, that gave us 10 frames per second, which is more of a slideshow than a video. So 640 by 480 resolution is definitely a no-go with this webcam. Here's a test of pushing the button on top of the camera to take a snapshot, which unfortunately seems to be fixed at 320 by 240 resolution with no way to change it. Well, that's pretty much it for using it as a webcam. Now let's see how well it works at capturing video. So I have that AV cable connected to the input on the back of the webcam, and as a first test, I have the video input connected to this Handycam, which is generating color bars, and the audio input connected to this cassette player. And right now that's the feed from the webcam, but if I go to advanced, go to video, alternate video, and change it to external video device plugged into camera, and under audio, it's set to line level auxiliary input instead of the microphone. And if I record a bit of that and play it back, you see the color bars that was recorded and the music from the cassette player. So it's working. Next, I have a pre-recorded video 8 tape being played on a Hi8 camcorder with a time-based corrector, and I'm going to use the webcam to capture the video from that.
Hey, just give me that.
Hey man, let me see that.
No, keep it on over here. Oh man, he played iced tea on his tape.
Great, he plays iced tea and talks about his dick.
No man, tea shreds on his tape. I heard it last night.
Alright, so I'll pick you up after your book.
Okay, Dad.
No big dates tonight. You'll be well rested for your history exam tomorrow.
Okay.
Yo, Paige! Anytime, anywhere, beautiful. Mr. Paige?
Despite the limited resolution, that actually didn't look too bad. And with the audio set to the CD quality option, the sound definitely is in stereo. But I did notice some dropped frames. So let me try connecting this to a faster computer to see if that will improve it. So here is my trusty ThinkPad X60, which is a Core 2 Duo. And if I can get the webcam to work with it, I'll use it to capture some video from this VHS VCR. Look at this weird error message I get. It says, the product requires a minimum of 32 megabytes of RAM. Your system has only negative 1,033 megabytes. Setup cannot continue. But I was able to install the drivers, and when you do that, you can use it with any program that can record video from a webcam, even including Windows Movie Maker.
Those choices can be critical when selecting a new roof. For example, just look at the difference that upgrading to an architectural shingle can make to the finished appearance of your home, not to mention the value it may add at resale time. Today, more people than ever are choosing the sophisticated yet natural look of architectural shingles for their home. Your Master Elite contractor can recommend which architectural shingle would be best for your home. Similarly, the addition of a distinctive ridge cap shingle can mean the difference between a run-of-the-mill roofing job and one that really stands out. When you get to the bottom line, there are two documents that embody everything that we've talked about in this video.
Well, that wasn't a total disaster, but unfortunately the frame rate is still pretty choppy, and due to the lack of a time-based corrector, the video from a VHS VCR is rather wibbly-wobbly. Using different software to capture the video also lets you change it to 352 by 288 resolution at 25 frames per second, which is what PAL video CDs use. And indeed, when I connect it to the output of my Mavica and switch it from NTSC to PAL, and give it a few seconds, it automatically corrects itself to the different video system. So this is a multi-system capture device. I popped open the cover, and there you can see the lens with the focus adjustment, the microphone. On this side of the board is the snapshot button and two chips. The larger one is a 4 megabit DRAM chip, and the smaller one is an AC97 audio chip, which means all the good stuff is under this cover, which is soldered in place. But luckily, it looks like there's only two tabs that are soldered, so it shouldn't be too difficult to remove. And there it is. The biggest chip on this side is a Sunplus SPCA505B, which is a USB chip that was used in many webcams in the early 2000s. And then this little chip is a Hitachi 49323, which is a 10-bit analog-to-digital converter, which takes the video signal from the CCD image sensor and digitizes it. And then finally down here is a Philips SAA7113, a very popular chip used in many video capture devices. It supports composite and S-video, but obviously the S-video capability is not used in this application. So this has a pretty decent video capture chip in it, but it's really limited by being fed through that cheap Sunplus USB webcam chip. So the only way you're getting 30 frames per second out of this, especially through a USB 1.1 interface, which is what this uses, is during what they call a talking head shot, where the camera remains perfectly still, and by the way, it does have a tripod mount on the bottom, and the only thing that's really moving is somebody's lips. But once you connect it to an external video source, especially from something like VHS tape where there's constant random noise in the picture, it just can't keep up, and that's why you get that choppy motion out of it. But I do need to cut it some slack, because remember, it's from 2001, and with that rebate, it cost less than $100, which was really quite cheap for both a webcam and a video capture device all in one product. And it was never meant for archival grade video preservation. As it says on the box, it was designed to port video and audio quickly and easily, and to create movies and share them with your friends via online video albums or websites, which were in their infancy back then, and due to the limited bandwidths and CPU powers and connection speeds, you were pretty much limited to low resolutions and low frame rates anyway. And if you remember websites like Ebaum's World, a lot of the video clips on there looked exactly like they were made using something exactly like this.
My girlfriend.